Hello friends, welcome to the week 1 video. The topic or the content of this first week is concept of forces and characteristics of forces. So in this particular week we are going to study in detail about the concept of forces and the characteristics of forces. As you know, the definition of force is in mechanics is any action that tends to maintain or alter the motion of the body or to distort it. So we all are surrounded by different types of forces during our day-to-day activity. We are generating the different types of forces, but we are not aware about it. So the force is any action. So whatever action we are doing in our routine life, it creates a force. The concept of force is commonly explained in terms of Isaac Newton's three law of motion. Three law of motions. According to the first law of Newton, a body that is at the rest or moving at a uniform rate in a straight line will remain in that state until some force is applied to it. So in the first principle, the Newton talks about the when the body is at rest or moving at a uniform rate in a straight line will remain in that particular state until some force is applied to it. Whereas in second law, he says that when an external force acts on a body, it produces an acceleration. Acceleration means change in the velocity of the body in the direction of the force. The magnitude of the acceleration is directly proportional to the magnitude of external force and inversely proportional to the quantity of matter in the body. So in the second law, Newton talks about the acceleration, that the force, whatever force we are applying, it tends to the change in the velocity of the body due to its magnitude, and this force is inversely proportional to the quantity of matter in the body. In third law, which is a well-known law of Newton's, that is third law, states that when one body exerts a force on another body, the second body exerts an equal force on the first body. So we are all aware about this, that when there is action there is a equal and opposite reaction. So in third law, Newton talks about the equal and opposite reaction when the action is applied. This principle of action and reaction explains why a force tends to deform a body, that is changing in its shape, whether or not it causes the body to move. The deformation of body can usually be neglected when the investigating its motion. So whereas there are different types of forces, if we see, there is a gravitational force, gravity force, usually it is called as a gravity force. In the gravity force, as it is well known fact, because of the gravitational force of the earth, whatever the body which is there are different types of forces. The first force is gravity force. The gravity force is the force that attracts any two objects with the mass. So whatever the force which attracts the body or which is acting by the earth, it is a gravitational force. Next is a applied force. The force that is applied to an object by a person or another person. So whenever you are pulling any object, you are applying force on the object to displace it, that is called as applied force. Next is a drag force. The drag force is the resistance force caused by the motion of the body through a fluid such as water or air. So here you can see the drag force. The person coming with the parachute is coming down, and the drag force, actually he is coming through the air, so that is why the drag force is acting in the opposite direction. So you can also see the direction of the force also. The next is the friction force. Friction force is the force that opposes the relative motion between the system in contact. So here if you see the man or woman sliding over a skiing, she is actually skiing on the snow, and when she slides, the friction between that slide and the snow causes the frictional force, and because of that the motion happens, so it is called as a frictional force. Next is a magnetic force. The magnetic force is the attraction or the repulsion that arises between the electrically charged particle because of their motion. So you can see here the magnetic force. So it may be a force of attraction or force of repulsion. It is all because of the electrical charge between the two objects. Next is a tension force. Tension force is transmitted through a rope, string or wire when pulled by force acting from the opposite side. So if you see here, whenever we are pulling any string, any rope, whatever force is get created, it is nothing but the tension force. So next is a spring force. The spring force is called a restoring force, because the force exerted by the spring always in the opposite direction to the displacement. So whenever you are exerting the force on the spring, the equal and opposite force will get created, or the force get restored, restoring in the spring, or the force restored in the spring give rise to the displacement in the opposite direction, and that force is called as a spring force. Next and the last is the buoyant force. Buoyant force, it is the force that causes the object to float. So whenever it may be in the air or it may be in the fluid, the force acting on the fully submerged or the partly submerged bodies, and it causes the float. Flotation of the body. So it is called as a buoyant force. Next we will see the characteristics of forces. Force has the following basic characteristic. First is magnitude. Usually the force is measured in the newton or kilonewton. When there is a small force, it is measured in newton. Whenever the large force is there, it is measured in the kilonewton. The force is having its direction, point of application and line of action also. The force is represented as a vector, that is arrow, with its magnitude. The next we will see the concept of force system. If you see, the force system is mainly divided into the two types, coplanar and non-coplanar forces. The coplanar forces again divided into the four types. The first is collinear, parallel, concurrent and non-concurrent forces, whereas non-coplanar forces are divided into three forces. First is parallel, concurrent and non-concurrent force system. So let us see what exactly is the collinear force system. When the line of action of all the forces of a system acts along the same line, this force system is called collinear force system. If you see the figure, all the forces are acting on same line or in the same line, so it is called as a collinear system. The name suggests that the system is acting, or the forces are acting, in the same line of action. The next is parallel forces. When the line of action of force of a system is parallel but may have opposite direction, this force system is called as a parallel system. So the line of action of the forces is parallel, but it may not have a same direction, it may have a opposite direction also. So the forces are having any direction, but they are acting in the line of action which is parallel to each other, so it is called as a parallel forces. Next is a coplanar force system. When the line of action of the set of forces lie in the single plane, it is called as a coplanar system. Then concurrent force system. The forces, when extended, pass through a single point, and the point is called as a point of concurrency. The line of action of all the forces meet at the point of concurrency. Concurrent forces may or may not be coplanar. So whenever the forces are passing through one single point, which is called as a point of concurrency, the forces are called as a concurrent force system. It is not necessary that always the concurrent force system is a coplanar. So it may or may not be coplanar. Then non-concurrent force system. When the force system do not meet at a common point of concurrency, this type of force system is called as a non-concurrent force system. So exactly opposite to the concurrent force system, here the forces are not passing through one common point of concurrency, that is why it is called as a non-concurrent force system. So friends, here we have discussed about the different types of forces like gravitational force, drag force, tension force and other different types of forces. Now different types of forces, then we have discussed about the force system. Then we have discussed about the force system, and as we know, it is divided into the major two types, that is coplanar forces and non-coplanar forces. We have discussed about the different system which are again divided into this, which are sub part of the coplanar and non-coplanar force system. So thank you friends. In the next week we are going to discuss about the resultant of the forces, and that will be delivered by NS Naik sir. Thank you very much.